the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
A smile's not a smile till it wrinkles your face. A bell's not a bell without ringing. A home's not a home.
For our Goodnight message on this Sunday, the 23rd of July, 2023, broadcasting from Dallas, Texas, United States of America, by your servant, Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco, we listen to this encouraging message in line with the Word of God for today, entitled Patience with Others.
Love in your heart wasn't put there to stay.
Today is World Day for Grandparents and the Elderly. And in fact, in life, we are asked to be patient, especially with the elderly and grandparents. But much more, we are supposed to be patient because this is exactly what the Lord told us in the Word of God for today. He spoke of the weeds and the wheat. And when the servants in that story wanted to uproot the weeds in order to save the wheat, the Lord said, let them grow together until the harvest. Patience. Wait until God Himself, the harvester, decides to act on that. As for you, learn to be patient. There is a story on patience. A New York City taxi driver arrived at the final stop for his shift. He honked. After waiting a few minutes, he honked again. Because it was his last stop, he considered pulling away. Instead, he put the car in park and walked up to the door. He knocked. He heard an elderly voice. Just a minute, he then heard the shuffling of bags moving across the floor. Then the door opened. It was a small woman in her 90s with a soft smile, wearing a print dress and a pillbox hat with a veil pinned on it. As she answered, the tax driver caught a glimpse inside the house. It looked as if no one had lived there for years. All the furniture was covered in sheets, no clocks on the wall and no knickknacks on the counters. Could you carry my bag? The lady asked. The cab driver walked her slowly down the steps of the front porch to the cab. Once in the cab, the lady handed the driver an address and asked, could you drive through downtown? It's not the shortest way, the driver answered. I'm in no hurry, I don't mind, she said. I'm on my way to hospice. The driver and the passenger shared a quick glimpse in the rearview mirror, enough for her to see his concern and continue. I don't have any family left. The doctor says I don't have very long. The driver quietly reached over and shut off the meter, then asked, what route would you like me to take? For the next 2 hours, they drove through the city. She showed the driver where she once worked, the neighborhood where she and her husband first lived, a furniture warehouse that had once been a ballroom when she was a girl. There were a few parts of town she asked the driver to slow down and she would sit, staring into the darkness, saying nothing. After a couple hours, she suddenly said, I am tired. Let's go now. They drove in silence to the address she had given him. When they arrived, two orderlies came out to the cab as soon as they pulled up. They must have been expecting her. The driver opened the trunk to take out the suitcase. As he shut the trunk, she was already in a wheelchair. How much do I owe you? She asked, reaching into her purse. Nothing, said the driver. You have to make a living, she answered. There are other passengers, he responded. Almost without thinking, the driver bent and gave the lady a hug. She held on tightly. You gave an old woman a little moment of joy. She said, thank you. The driver gave a final squeeze of the lady's hand, and the two turned to go their separate ways. As he got into the car and glanced over to her, the door was shut. He didn't pick up any more passengers that night. In fact, he could hardly speak. What if that woman had gotten an angry or impatient driver? What if she got someone who refused to get out and go to her door, refused to take the time driving around the city? The taxi driver couldn't shake the feelings that this single moment may be one of the most important moments of his life. We can treat our interactions as just that, an interaction when in fact there may be an important moment waiting to be discovered. The woman is not only the one to benefit that day. One could argue that the cab driver got the most from their experience. A life to live with that memory and that feeling of what he did, the significance of the moment, and the knowledge of how precious life is. I'm sure all this and more stuck with him every day. Not every interaction has this level of potential, but we will never know unless we try. Take a few moments to find more patience with the people in your life. This might be listening more intently to your spouse, enjoying a conversation with your kids, taking time to check in with a neighbor, or listening to a co-worker's struggle with something outside of work. Whatever it is, give it your attention. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good night, as it dreams.
Same to you, Father.
You might think love is a treasure to keep, a feeling to cherish and hold. But love is a treasure for people to share. You keep it by letting it go. Love isn't love. Isn't love till it's free? Love in you.